Good morning, everyone. Hello, students. I hope you all are healthy and doing your studies properly. So today we are again back with your videos for accounts. So as you all know, we were on the chapter of Introduction to Accounting, and we are following the book of T.S. Garhiwal's Double Entry Bookkeeping. Today our topic is accounting cycle. So far we have discussed about evolution of accounting, the meaning of accounting, meaning of bookkeeping, relationship of bookkeeping and accountancy. So today we are going to discuss about the topic of accounting cycle or the accounting process. So behind the discussion of this topic, what are the learning objectives of following or doing an accounting cycle? First of all, to make financial accounting of business activities easier for business owners, to follow steps in an accounting cycle, to provide comprehensive financial performance reporting, to analyze the business. You all must have gone through the PDF sent to you all. So according to that, we have covered evolution of accounting, accounting, its meaning and features, bookkeeping, its characteristics, accountancy, relationship of bookkeeping and accountancy, objectives of accounting, attributes of accounting, then limitations of accounting, nature of accounting. Today our topic of discussion is accounting cycle, and in this week further we are going to discuss about uses of accounting and also systems and branches of accounting. I hope you all would have been able to solve your worksheet we have sent you yesterday. So proceeding with the topic, let me first give you an example of an e-commerce company, that is FirstCry. You all know this name, FirstCry. So its brand ambassador is Mr. Amitabh Bachchan, and it's a big store for little ones. It's an Asia's largest shopping store for kids and baby products, operated by Brain Bees Solution. It's an e-commerce company, that is its deal in online business. It has its retail outlets also. Then moreover, they deal in clothes, footwear, toys, games, books, diapering products, feeding and nursery products. FirstCry was founded in 2010. It is a private store. It has about 5 crore employees. Its latest biggest deal was $396 million. Its main business is internet retailing. But we can also see few showrooms of FirstCry in our nearby places. It has venture capital backed by Mahindra. Venture capital backed. Venture means business. Capital is money invested, and backed means financed. So in their business, money is invested by Mahindra Group. So as it's a partner which is introducing and promoting the same company. Its primary and main office is in Pune. So we have to discuss the accounting cycle. So for accounting purpose, a company's source document for the recording of merchandise. Now, merchandise is the dealing of products between the customer and the supplier. Purchase is the supplier's invoice. Suppose all of you place orders online. We go for Amazon, we go for Flipkart, we place orders, and when we receive parcels, you must have seen on the parcels that an invoice is pasted, a white paper is pasted on it, and on that the name of the company, the shipment company, the company who is couriering, doing the service of courier, and the detail of the product, quantity, amount, other terms and conditions, tax if any, all is described in the form of an invoice. So invoice is what? A statement. Now you all, if you have a packet with you and an invoice is attached, so you all must bring it and look at it, that it's a source of document that is retained with the company. Its copy is retained with the company as a proof and as a source of preparing financial statements. So it is supported, invoice is also supported by company's purchase order and receiving ticket. So you must have noticed that on that invoice, a ticket is put. Ticket means that you have to purchase a stamp ticket, that in which area you are sending the courier. A company's source documents for its weekly payroll. Now, weekly payroll is, suppose we are saying that FirstCry is making the records of their sales, records of their interactions with the customers on weekly basis. Now, they are keeping the invoice, that they are keeping the records of the documents, and are the employees' time cards also. Now, you must have noticed, if you are not satisfied with the product, you are given an executive customer care number, that is toll-free number. You rang up that number and you are connected to the customer executive of the company whose product you are using. Not the courier company, not the shipment company, but you are connected with direct the customer care executive. So in that case, what happens? Employees' time cards are also maintained. At what time the executive is receiving a phone call, what complaint he is addressing, what are the various solutions he is giving, and in how much time he is ready to give a proper solution to the customer. And manufacturer's production records will also include source documents such as material requisition form. Now this is another aspect. Suppose you went a FirstCry outlet in Amritsar, it is in Mall Road. So at Mall Road, you visit there, you need a particular tricycle for a kid of 4 years, and in that case you are not admiring the product which is on display. You need a good one, you have seen it on internet, but in that case, now what they will ask you, they will ask you to fill a material requisition form. So this material requisition form, employee time cards, weekly payroll, invoices, purchase order, tickets. So what are these? These are source documents. Now the one who collects it is following the very first step of accounting, that is collection of data. So as we were discussing that a simple tricycle was not available at the outlet, so they make you fill the material requisition form, and in that case they will arrange the product and will make it available for you. But one thing, it is there that they had a partnership or they had a collaboration of their workings with all these companies. Net means India Ki Pharmacy, because they are dealing with baby products also, baby feeding and nursing products also. Amazon, Purple.com, Flipkart, IMG, YourDoorstep.com, Nykaa.com, these are very famous brands. So they have a collaboration with FirstCry to make the availability of products at your doorstep. So as I told you that I went that FirstCry showroom and I want to buy a tricycle for a 4-year-old baby girl. So I talked there with a man and the name was Rajiv. Rajiv was a salesperson there and he actually shows the products, and moreover he maintains accounts for the same showroom outlet, for the same retail outlet. So I had a word with him. So he told me that he works as an accountant for this medium sized outlet. No doubt company is very big, but a retail outlet for which he is working, that is a medium sized retail showroom. He is only dealing with toys part. Rajiv's job is to process the financial information of his company and prepare financial statements. So what is this? Processing the information and preparing the statements. So this is accounting cycle. These statements then are reviewed by management to take decisions. In order to perform his work, Rajiv follows a series of steps for the collection, processing and reporting of financial transactions. Again, I am repeating, a series of steps for the collection of data, processing of data and reporting of all events and dealings is called accounting cycle. Now, he is following some steps. First of all, step one, that is collection and analysis. So, Rajiv must first collect and analyze all of the financial transactions undertaken by his company. He analyzes each transaction in order to determine how it affects the financial health of the company. Because he was an accountant and he has to consider at the top priority the financial health of the company. For example, Rajiv review all the sales conducted each day and all the payments made to suppliers. So in this way, he collected and analyzed the data. Now he jumped on step 2, that is journalizing the transactions. After collecting all the financial transactions, Rajiv records every transaction in a general journal. So this is a form of accounting, a format of accounting, a prescribed form in which the dealings are recorded. A journal general is a journal where all transactions are recorded in chronological order as they occur. Suppose in a week, say VRF, May 4, May 5, May 6, May 7, May 8, May 9, May 10. So all it occurs in the month of May, in the second week of May. So for example, Rajiv will record all the company sales for each day in the journal ledger. So when he will prepare journal, after that he will go to ledger. So this is the third step, that is posting to journal ledger. Once the entries have been recorded in journal, they have been recorded in the sequence they occur, day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4, or in a day, in the morning, then in the afternoon, evening, night shift. So he recorded in them that way. Then he record all the entries separately. Now if he is dealing with toys only, plastic toys, semi-plastic toys, rubber toys, so he has categorized his products and now he is recording each and every particular item in a different format, that is in the ledger. He will record sales in the sales account, bill in expense account, utilities, supplies, marketing. He may post to the journal ledger at the end of week or month. He did not do these things daily. He only collects data daily, but he prepares, he follows step 2 and 3 once a week or once a month only. Then he jumped to step 4, unadjusted trial balance. Now, every day a new sale is made, a new purchase is made, someone has taken the product on credit, someone has given immediate cash and you have given him discount also. So on daily basis transactions are different. But trial balance, as you all have done in previous weeks, trial balance is that you are taking out extract of different heads of account in a single format. But that's so this is the reason why after all the transactions have been posted to the journal ledger in the appropriate accounts, Rajiv will ensure that all debits and credits in the ledger are balanced. Now there are two terms, debits and credits. The expenses, the things, the transactions, the events, the dealings which decrease your profit is debit. All the items which give you profit, which increase your turnover, which increase your profit is credit. Okay, a simple example of debit and credit. Now, all of you bring a statement copy of either of your parent, either of your mother or father. Bring a statement copy of any bank. You must open that copy. You must see on that if you have taken out money, then bank says debited by 7,000. If you have taken 7,000, bank says your account has been debited by 7,000. It means it's an expense. It is a loss for you. So it is debited, decreased. In case I have to pay you 10,000, I have given a check. Now your account is increased. So it is credited. So debit means decrease and credit means increase. So he make all debits and credits and then balance the accounts. So for every debit entry, there should be a credit entry that keeps the books in balance. Like on one side we are recording debits, on one other side we are recording credits. What we are paying, what we are receiving, we are recording them side by side. In a sequence we are recording them. So there should be a proper balance and matching should be there. Both sides must be matching, as we have done in the case of balance sheet also. So for example, if Rajiv finds a receipt for some supplies purchased by his company, he will debit the amount as an asset and credit the vendor's account as the amount paid or payable to the supplier. Now see the example here. Suppose Rajiv has bought certain products for his showroom from another company. In that case, if his asset is increasing, so he will debit, he will increase the asset, he will debit the amount because he is paying, his cash is reducing and his asset is increasing. So both debit and credit sides are equal. Debits are recorded on left side and credits are recorded on right side. Debits are always equal to credit. Now if Rajiv finds that an account is not in balance, he will need to find out why it is not balanced, and moreover he has to correct the problem also. So this is one of the part of the accounting process. So first of all, we have to collect the data, generalize the data, post the data in the ledger, make trial balance for the adjustments, provide for unrecorded things. If still there is some difference in the debit and credit, then we have to correct it. Rajiv's all work is going on very smoothly. His accounts are balanced. But one thing which he has to do, now he has to jump to the step number 5, that is adjustments. He will make all necessary adjustments to bring accounts and balances up to the date, current date. So Rajiv company utilizes an accrual accounting method. Income is recognized when incurred. Okay, now there is a term, accrual accounting method. Accrual accounting method means that we record when it is actually received. Suppose I have to receive a money of rupees 2 lakh from a customer who has bought few goods and on credit basis. But I will record it only when the money is actually received. So in that case, I am following accrual accounting method. This means Rajiv will record income when the company, even if the company has not received the money, and he will record expenses even if the company has yet to pay the bill. So as per accrual concept, the accounting concept which has been made by the formulative agencies of accounts. So what do they say? That we have to provide for losses in advance. So in future, suppose the company is predicting that maybe their sales will be less as compared to current. So in that way, they are preparing for their losses. That is, they are following accrual system. Now, we have covered 5 steps here. First of all, collection of data, making journal, posting them into ledger, then preparing adjusted trial balance, equalizing all debits and credits, then balancing the accounts. After then, even if there is certain deprivation, in that case, we have to go for adjustments and to balance the accounts so that it should be made up to date till the current dates prevailing in the situation. So, what we can summarize here, what is an accounting cycle? An accounting cycle is identifying the transactions, recording journal entries, posting ledger entries, unadjusted trial balance, then adjusted entries, adjusted trial balance, making financial statements. Now, what are financial statements? Making of trading account, making of profit and loss account, and making of balance sheet. When we make all the 3 accounts, it means we are making financial statements. Once the balance sheet has been made, assets are equal to liabilities. As we have discussed in the previous videos, assets when become equal to liabilities, only then our accounting cycle is about to finish and we close our books of account. We did not record anything further. Anything which happens after closing will go to next accounting year. So in this topic, what are the various key terms which we have to cover? First of all, deferrals. Money spent before seeing any resulting revenue or cash received before delivering a service or good. I went to the market. I purchased a refrigerator. I paid all the amount, but the product is not in my home. I have not got the possession. So what is it? A deferral. Why is it a deferral for the company? Unless the product is delivered, the transaction is not over. For example, buying office supplies that you will use in the future, or advance payment made from a customer. So what are these? These are deferrals. Next key term is accruals. Revenues are one which did not get immediately recorded at the time. For example, a bill which you have sent to the customers 2 weeks after giving them consulting services, or expenses you didn't immediately pay for. For example, rent you own a landlord but you have not paid yet. Accruals are what? Due but not given. Like we have done the word outstanding. So accruals and outstanding are same. Suppose I have to receive money, then it is accrued. If I have to pay, then it is outstanding. If I have to pay some amount of money, then it is outstanding. If I have to receive amount of money for which I have taken the services, for which I have delivered the services, then that is accrual. Next is accounting cycle. It is a collective process of series of steps. Begin when a transaction occurs and ends when it is recorded in statements. So it starts from analyzing, then recording, posting it, also looking for adjustments. If anything is not recorded, if anything is recorded wrongly, so that are our adjustments in the beginning as well as at the end. After that, balancing and then preparing financial statements. Financial statements such as profit and loss account and balance sheet. 10K is the recent updation by the US accounting reports that they introduce a new standard in accounting for recording of information, and it's a new updation and amendment in the accounting process. Okay, let us have a quick look of what we have done today. First of all, suppose a company received 12,000 as sales on their toy products. So this is what? Starting point of the accounting cycle. Now that 12,000 will be entered on the same date it occurred to align it in chronological order. Now what is this alignment called? It is called journal. After that, the accountant entered 12,000 in ledger account. Because he has made sales, so he will record it in sales. Accountant enter it in the assets also, because if he had made a sale, his asset been reduced and he has received cash also. So he will cover all the necessary items which is affected by one transaction. So after recording, we can say, suppose company owes 28,000 as unearned revenue. Company has to get rupees 28,000 from a customer from whom he has to receive money. They have delivered them goods but not received. So what is it? It's their unearned revenue. Revenue is to be received but not actually received by them. Needs to take out 8,000 at the end of supply expenses. Also, they know that at the end of 1 month, they have to pay 8,000 by the way of tax, by the way of any government dues. So they are keeping it aside. So what is this? They are doing adjustments. And one thing more, they have to record it on left and right side in a T form. They prepare it in the form of T. One side they record debits, all things which reduce their profits. One side they record credits, all the incomes they are receiving, and they record it in the form of general. They record it in chronological order. So this is all what we called accounting process, the accounting cycle. For better clarity of the concept, you must refer the given link so that you can have a hold of the topic. And after clearing all your doubts, try to give answers of the listed questions here. What is the purpose of accounting cycle? Why are financial statements critical to one's business? Why is an accounting cycle sometimes called bookkeeping cycle? List all the steps of the accounting cycle. Suppose if I buy a new MacBook Pro for my business, tell me what will be its effect on accounting records. And next question is, who are bookkeepers? So all of you must go through the PDF, listen to the school link, and kindly refer to the given links of YouTube also, so that you can have more clarity of your concepts. Do the questions. Thank you.